You are in Mises Poetry Cast. Repeat. You are in Mises Poetry Cast. Enjoy. Enjoy.
And now we get to give back the torture that Misha has done to us. So, Misha loves working at a bookstore. Misha loves the ground. Misha loves to sing and we duet together. Misha loves Pink Floyd. Misha loves to open presents. Misha loves Montana. Misha loves her bones. Misha loves bro hugs. And the creative process. Misha loves the mail more than most eighth graders. Misha loves crimson lipstick and the smell of old books. Misha loves to get in the playpen and wrap herself in three blankets. Misha loves to be with other dogs. Misha loves dim sum and buffalo wings. She loves other cats. She loves to eat horse and sheep drippings and to glomp. Misha loves to sit on top of the computer desk, and she loves everyone and is loved back. Misha.
So a lot of people name their pets Misha. So, okay, this is the last poet. I do see Stephen Corey in the distance. Did you bring a poem by any chance to read? I take it as no.
There's always a poem.
There's always a poem. Well, we've invited folks to linger and step up to the mic for another round, so maybe we'll hear something from Stephen. But I'm going to give you my last some words for you. I'm going to start with a poem that we wrote together in class. I mean, it was one of the first assignments that I gave to you, and I took it up myself. I think it was a metered poem. It may not be metered now, I'm not sure. But just to, you know, as I've said, I think teachers need to model, you know, do what you assign, right? And I can't say that I've been as tough on myself with revision as you all clearly have, but here it is. He says, "I like your skin. Goosebump bare arms, I push my daughter's stroller, her brother's warm body pressed to my back, blue shoes on wrong feet as if split. Half of him could go this way, half that. We're going on a venture, he chirps, searching for birds, sings poopy diaper to her delight, level with truck tires and dog jaws. Anything could happen to them. Half myself, half their own making, humming the wedding march into loud mornings where their dragons straddled, tail split like two swords curved out." For my babies. For my babies. So I don't think that I made you do a sestina. I did make them do a lot of forms, but the sestina is pretty challenging. As you may know, every stanza has six lines, and each of those six end words are repeated in every stanza. And then the final stanza, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes, there are six stanzas. In the sixth stanza, each of those end words have to come back. So it's a real exercise in that kind of, you know, this is good for the accountant in the room. There's a lot of quantitative, you know, a lot of logical thinking and also some poetic leaping. So as we've learned, workshops are sometimes difficult. People will say, "Keep this, I love this," and someone else will say, "I hate this." So you get these, you know, mixed messages, and how do you revise a poem? Well, I had a poem that had, I've done a lot of meditation and yoga classes. I'm very fond of going to yoga ashrams when I can. And so the guru comes up a lot in my poetry. In my workshop, which I have now online with some peers, that everyone agreed that I should take the guru out. So what I did was put him in six, in each of the six stanzas, many times over and over. Workshop advice: take the guru out. He's too hocus pocus for an American poem, Orange cloth, brown flesh, another continent enters the room when he's there. Part naked, crystal eyes, white hair, encircled by women who eat brewer's yeast for breakfast. No, the guru has to go. To East, the peaceful guru, a repotted banana plant in American soil. Choose a financial planner, a woman rabbi, anything but his bald patience smothering the line. He hovers like a flock of white birds over lovers on the coast, their picnic lunch of fried chicken lying there, hopelessly exposed. Just the sound of it, guru, sounds too frou-frou, archaic, a white lie for what you really want in American art. Chinese takeout glare, sidewalk smothered in butts, chewed gum. Hairy women hang his picture by the birthing bed, women who pray in private or chant their musty breath in airport entourage, mothers with babies in arms begging the dead guru to bless them, inject India in American souls. A replica Swami hangs on white walls in the ashram next to black and white portraits. Mother Teresa, the only woman. Martin Luther King, the only American. His hippy-dippy image belongs there, not in your poem. Kudzu and gurus, aurora borealis scarves and grandmothers, big no-nos. Americans make ourselves other holy figures. They're invisible or male and white. Girl, here's our advice. Lose the guru. And this is the last poem that I'll read for the evening. Don't forget to place your orders for this incredible book. I will have ordered a box of them, so if you want, I can sell it to you at the cost and throw in a free chapbook to boot. I want to say that Virginia and I will be featured at the poetry picnic at Chase Street Elementary School happening next week. May 6th, I think it is. I'm not sure. I can't remember. May 6th? Oh, geez. Email me if you're interested in attending. It's an afternoon next week at the elementary school. Should be a lot of fun. And, take classes with me if you love art and education at the same time. That would be great. Okay, last poem. Mother less, mother more. Mother goose, mother guess which mother they'll love best. Den mother, dun mother, fit mother, fat mother, stepmother, stop mother, hip mother, hot mother, grandmother, grind mother, smother all the time, mother. Mother load, mother land, mother bored by all she's planned. Host mother, post mother, modern slice of toast mother, skip the jokes and roast mother, pocket full of post-its mother. Ring around the collar, mother, pinch a penny now, mother. Mother speaking, mother ease, mother may I, mother please. Scrambled easy, slice of cheese. Find a mother, pick her up, and all the day you'll have a cutlet. Folded laundry, full service, a spa. Mother cheering, mother swearing, sis boom ba. Mother see as mother do. Bad mother, good mother, done the best she could, mother. Now you see her, now you don't, and you never have the one you want. Thank you, and thank you for coming.
Misha's Poetry Cast is a production of the Office of Information Technology in the UGA College of Education. Melissa Conman Taylor, producer. Podcast copyright 2010, the University of Georgia.